chat. I'm sorry, I disassociated. I'm sorry, Blade. Hi. I'm sorry, I disassociated for too many minutes. Hope everyone's having an amazing 4th of July! Okay, you excited for those fireworks? Let's go. Let's see, let me catch up to chat. I didn't forget anything. Fingers crossed. Let's see. Seraphs, welcome in. Thank you so much for the lurk. I appreciate it. Hug. Welcome in. Congrats on first today. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Let's see. Deco, welcome in. Joma, welcome in as well, and thank you so much for the giant emote. Welcome in, Tilo. Thank you so much for the lurk. Jake, also welcome in. Am I not live on YouTube yet? I should be. I hit the button minutes ago. Okay, I should be now? That's really weird. I guess I have to stay on the page after I hit the button. Because I hit the go live button on there a while ago. Like, right after I started streaming. That's crazy. Good thing to note for next time. Good thing. YouTube weird. YouTube weird, I guess. YouTube has been weird. I don't know what's been going on, chat. But anytime I try to go watch Big Sis Furry stream, her chat never pops up for me. And the same for Papa Ala too. Her stream chat doesn't pop up like for 15-20 minutes. I have to sit there. I'm like, I want to say hi, but I can't because the chat's not there. And eventually it'll pop up and I'll finally get to see the chat and actually type in it. The rest of the page seemingly works fine, but it's just the chat and it eventually comes up. Do you have ad blockers on? I think my browser comes with one. It happens in all my browsers that I can tell. So I have Firefox, I have Opera, and I very occasionally use Edge as well. I know, chat, I use Edge sometimes. I admitted it. It is handy sometimes, okay. But some water. But yeah, I don't know what it is. I tried to Google it and it just said it does that sometimes. That's what I got from that. So I don't know, it's been pretty annoying. It started happening like randomly too. Like out of nowhere. Hello Zoe, welcome in! Thank you so much for the whole 60 stream watch streak. Oh my goodness. Fear crimes against humanity. You've been sentenced to become an NFT. Rip Griffin? No. NFT? Bad. Awful. Gross. Disgusting. If we're gonna make me something, at least make me a really cool crypto coin. Like Dogecoin, but like Conecoin? Foxcoin? Griffcoin? One of those? I don't know. If I have to be sentenced to something, don't let it be an NFT. Let it at least be a cool hip cryptocurrency. Hello Tranquil, welcome in, good to see you. That way at least I can say Griffcoin to the moon. But yeah, chat, yeah, that's a big streak right there. We are playing some... Oh, I almost hit my water over. Oh my goodness, that would've been awful. Playing some Little Witch in the Woods today. Apparently, the fishing update came out, so, you know... Like, I've been waiting for it to come out to play it, and we didn't have anything we were doing today, so I figured... Let's get it started today, why not? Was there anything else I really felt like? So it's gonna be super cute, comfy time. with making potions and stuff. Maybe some fishing if we can get to it. I don't know how far in you have to be for it. Also, Hug, thank you so much for opening the YouTube. Thank you. Hi, Bunny. Good to see you. Yeah, exactly, chat. If you don't know Bunny, you're missing out. She's amazing. She's super cute. She's super... I was gonna say super creepy, but she's not super creepy. She's only kind of creepy. She's absolutely wonderful. She's amazing. She has mega cute art. Highly recommend. That's right. Give her like 4 shoutouts. She deserves all of them. She's so amazing. Also, Jake, thank you so much for the 35 stream watch streak. Happy 4th of July. Anyone doing anything today? I know, Jake, you said it was your mom's birthday and anniversary today. I hope she has an absolutely wonderful birthday and anniversary and 4th of July. Here, wait. Oh, wait, let me get water real quick. Super cute, kind of creepy? Exactly. Alright. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jake's mom. Happy birthday to you. There you go. See, I remember. I remember at least some of the things that chat tells me. Let's see. Welcome in today! Good to see you! Bunny keeps doing late night streams and I keep missing because I fall asleep. Same! I was already in bed whenever Bunny started streaming, and for some reason stupid mobile wouldn't count my view. And so I had to get up and turn her on my pewter. So that way, I didn't lose my watch streak. I'm at 78. I'm at 78. I can't lose my watch streak. I'll cry. I'll be so sad. Bunny's the only one I've managed to have a watch streak in. I'll be so sad when I lose it. Feeling sick today, mumbling Dan. Oh, Tranquil, I hope you feel better soon. I'm so sorry to hear that. Sick days suck. There's like a good feeling that you get from like laying down and like resting, but I don't know if it, I don't think it outweighs the being sick part. Being sick sucks, so I hope you feel better soon. Hope you get all that rest. Make sure you drink plenty of water. Oh no, chat. That just died. Oh no. 1 second, chat. I can't hear you, chat. One second. I can hear again. Hi. My ears are working again. Let's go. Let's see. Yep, we'll be joining them once I wake up from last night celebrating. Heck yeah, let's go. I'm sorry. It's okay, Bunny. You stream on your schedule. No one else's. Also, thank you for the head pats. It's nice tummy. Oh, tummy. Tummy aches are the absolute worst. You have a heat pack on it to get better? I hope you do. I hope you feel better soon. What just happened? My ears died. I got too much fluff in my ears. I had to clean them out. Wait, what? You can hear us normally? All the weird things I've been saying? You heard those? I hear everything, chat. I go to Bunny's house a lot. I'm in the walls. I'm in the walls of Bunny. We have lots of tea parties in here. But no, I meant more like, I don't even know what I meant. I can't read your chat messages if my headset isn't on. Don't think about it too hard. Also, hello, Savino. Welcome in. Good to see you. Cute, yummy ears. Oh, heck. Don't eat the ears. Huh? Don't think about it too hard. It's just like whenever someone's like, wait, I can't hear you. Let me put my glasses on. You don't think about it too hard, chat. It just makes sense. Also, if you don't wear glasses, that's a very real thing. At least to me. So I say that it makes sense because, like, if you need glasses and you don't have them on, more of your brain power, like sensory brain power, is going to like trying to figure out what your eyes are parsing. So your other senses feel a little lesser than what they normally are, because you usually don't have to stress hard enough to look at things when you're wearing glasses as opposed to when you're not. So it really feels like your hearing gets worse when you don't have glasses on, because you're focusing more on trying to figure out what you're looking at than you would if you had your glasses on. There you go, chat. There's the science behind that. At least the Griffin science. Well, I mean, in some cases it works if they have hearing aids built into their glasses. That too. Or you can close your eyes and become like Daredevil. I don't know who Daredevil is. That's so true. My glasses are off. I feel like I can't do anything. When I take my glasses off, I'm like, huh? What did you say? Can you like shout it directly into my ear, please? Just like, huh? And I put my glasses on. I'm like, okay, you can stop shouting. Like, I can hear you whisper. It's fine. Just quiet. Quiet. Like, legitimately. All of your other senses get worse whenever you're not wearing glasses. Crazy. Daredevil is a comic superhero. He's blind, but his superpower is echolocation like a bat. Oh, I see. I do that sometimes too. Not the echolocation, I'm not a bat. Though that would be pretty cool. Sometimes if I don't have my glasses or I don't want to put them on or something, I just like close my eyes, like if I'm trying to listen to something. Just be like, okay. Turn off as many senses as I can to focus on the thing. Chidobi! Welcome in, good to see you! Hello. Hope you're having a wonderful 4th of July. Heck yeah. Hello! We were just talking about how your senses get worse when you don't have your glasses on. So it's a perfectly acceptable thing to say, wait, I can't hear you, let me put my glasses on. I slept in and took a shower? Let's go. Sounds like a pretty great day so far. Maybe you go get a burger later? Heck yeah. What kind of burger? Cheeseburger? Quarter pounder? Lettuce? Tomato? Burger? My favorite burger, chat, is lettuce, tomato. You gotta salt and pepper the tomato too. It's not the same if you don't salt and pepper the tomato. Can I send links in chat? I can show you. You can try. I don't know if the filter is gonna hit it, but you can try. I think I turned it off, so you should be able to. But I don't think anyone's tested since I turned it off. So it's a place I go to a lot. Oh. Yeah, my favorite burger is lettuce, tomato, salt and pepper tomato, because it's not the same if you don't salt and pepper it. And then a little bit of mayo on the bun and cheese. Yeah. Usually grilled burgers, though I haven't figured out the way to grill burgers that make it really tasty. I don't know what it is. My burgers don't taste the same as other people's grilled burgers. Tastes inferior. I need to figure out the burger magic. So I've had some pretty dang good grilled burgers, chat. It's a very high bar. I want to meet it. It's real good. Hey! It didn't block the link. Let's go! Oh, that's so good. Oh, I'm so jealous. They have, you know, a burger is gonna be amazing if it has that red and white paper under it. It's perfect. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. I can taste it. Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm jealous. I'm jealous. Oh my good. I'm jealous. I'm so jealous. You won me over. Chat's having burgers tonight. Let's go. The fries are... Yeah, the fries look really good too. But man, I'm jealous. I want a burger like that. Burger party. Let's go. How does Hudo burgers taste? Well, I did the cooking, so... I don't know. I don't think I've ever had a burger cooked by Hudo before. That I can recall, anyway. That I can recall. What about that fried onion mayo sauce? Wait, fried onion mayo sauce. Fried onion. I never heard of that before. Fried onion mayo sauce. What? What? I don't know what that is. Gotta see if they're open today, though. Oh, yeah, you should. You should. Oh, my mouth is watering. I need to close the picture. I'm already getting hungry. I just had a snack and I'm already getting hungry. Oh, that looks so good. Oh. Oh my god, I'm so jealous. I'm so jealous. Apologies, it's okay. It's okay. Thank you for sharing. Great picture. Great place. I don't even know what it is, but just by the wrapper, I can tell it's a great place. Places that have those red and white wrappers like that, that they use for like their burgers, you know it's gonna hit so hard. It's gonna be so good. It's gonna be so greasy. It's gonna be amazing. Oh, it's gonna be such a good burger. I don't have anywhere near me that I know of that makes burgers like that. And they're really dying out too, because usually only like oldie diner style places do that kind of stuff. It's a local place. It costs about the same as fast food with 100% times the quality. Oh, heck yeah, heck yeah. That's amazing. That's so good. Honestly, with the fast food thing, fast food has been getting way more expensive. So that's good that it at least costs the same. But I would absolutely do the same in your place. Deep fry the onion and shove that in the mayo. Really? Wait, but then... How do they get it out of the bottle if you just shove the fried onions in the bottle, in the mayo? You know it's a good burger if you have to bite it twice to get a full bite? Oh, true, 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 true. Make your own mayo? Ooh. Better yet, Kewpie mayo? I've never had Kewpie mayo, but I've heard that it's like the best mayo. Yeah, they serve quarter pound burgers, or like in the pick is third pound. Ooh. Ooh, that's a good deal. That's a really good deal. For Griffin Mind Borkin? Yeah, I'm still drooling. I'm still drooling, chat. I need to figure out how to make a burger like that. They're so good. Welcome Indita and welcome Bray. Good to see you both. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Also, thank you for the hydrate. Gotta stop. Exactly. I gotta stop looking at the burger picture. The picture's not even on my screen anymore. I'm still thinking about it. Ever since I learned how to make it, I don't buy mayo anymore. Whoa. Is it hard to make mayo? I've actually never looked. Ah. Good water. Pretty easy. Ooh. What do you feel you're lacking in the burger in terms of taste? The good taste? Definitely it's the patty. 100% it's the patty. I don't know how to describe it. It just doesn't taste as good as every other grilled burger that I've had. So what I do, chat, is I get the ground beef, because I don't have pre-made patties. I get my ground beef, I put it in a bowl, I put garlic salt, I put pepper, I put a little bit of seasoning salt, or steak seasoning, seasoning salt, something like that. The red bottle thing. It's kind of like a red seasoning, reddish seasoning. And onion powder and a little bit of garlic powder. That's what I put in mine. Then I mix it all up and I form it into patties and then I cook it on the grill. But it feels like it's missing a taste. It's missing something. I don't even know how to describe it. Isn't mayo basically egg and oil? Egg, salt, mustard, vinegar, and then you add oil while blending it until it's got the consistency you want. Whoa. I see. What ground beef do you buy? That's a big question. When I buy it, I get the higher quality stuff, not standard stuff. I usually buy ground beef from my burritos and I make it really good. I think I buy the brand of my grocery store, like Publix brand. And I think usually we get the green label one, which is like low fat, like a lower fat. I don't remember if this is green or blue, but it 80-20 meat to fat, or maybe it's like 85-15, 87-13, something like that, like a low fat. I don't wanna get up and go look. Let's see. On paper, that sounds like it should be good. I mean, it's good. It just the burger that I described that I make with the seasonings. It's okay, but it feels really plain in comparison to other grilled burgers I've had. And I'm wondering if maybe I'm missing something. Like, do people put, like, soy sauce in their meat? Do people put, like, barbecue sauce in their meat? I don't know. But I certainly didn't get the memo. Also, welcome to Peru. Good to see you! Happy 4th of July! Hope you're having a wonderful day. Oh, maybe get something not so lean. The fat gives a richness to the flavor? That might be it. Maybe. Because that's the only kind of meat that I've used. Might have to get a special thing for with more fat, I guess, for burger. Cause I've stopped cooking burgers. I get so tired of the taste. Cause it's not a bad taste, but it's a very boring taste. It's a very boring taste. Like I said, I put all that seasoning in it, and I can never even like. It just tastes like regular meat, hamburger meat. I don't know what it is. Maybe I'm just not putting enough seasoning in there. But I also don't want to over-season it, you know? Because you can't really fix a salty burger. But yeah, I don't know, just... It's like it's missing something. Maybe I'm not seasoning it enough. Maybe my meat just needs more fat. Maybe, I don't know. But... Just the taste has been so bland, so boring that I stopped making burgers because I got to the point where I'm like, oh, it's burger night. Okay. I guess I'll have a burger tonight. That made me very sad. Also, welcome in, Simon. Good to see you. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Also, welcome in, Rusty. Good to see you too. Hope you're also having a great day. Happy 4th of July. I keep the burger simple, just salt and pepper. Do add some oil or other fat and mush it with my hands right before cooking. Oh. I see. I might try that. Add a little bit of olive oil to it? Dang, feels bad, poor Griffin. Yeah. That's why I wanna know, chat. I wanna know your secrets. I wanna know your burger secrets. How do you make a burger? That way, maybe I can make a better burger. Because... Oh, we like to share our recipes. Share our knowledge. So that way we can all become better cooks, better chefs, one might say. Make like a 5-star burger. Heck yeah. Add a little barbecue sauce to the beef? Oh. That's kind of what I was thinking. I feel like I was missing something, though. If they do add barbecue sauce to it, I've never noticed it. Because barbecue sauce is generally really sweet. And a lot of the burgers I've had were more on the salty side. Also, it's Cohen. Welcome in, welcome in. Good to see you. Hope you're having a wonderful 4th of July. I got work today. Oh no, Rusty! I hope work goes well. I hope it goes really slow so you can just hang out. Oh, heck. Hi, Eddie! Ooh, I've been wanting pancakes lately. Probably not olive oil? Oh, I see. So more like a canola or maybe peanut oil? I told my sister about the burger pick and she said there's a pretty solid place nearby, so yeah, I'll be back soon. Alright, Jumbo! Have a wonderful time with your sister and the burgers. I hope they live up to your expectations. Share the bacon pancakes? If I have to. Can't go wrong with a little lard mixed in the meat. Really, the meat before cooking really makes a difference in the texture. Whoa, really? Like I said, I never get pre-made patties. I always make my own patties, and I do like make sure to mix it and stuff. I don't know. Maybe I'll try again sometime soon. We'll see. But yeah, chat. Enough about me drooling about the burger. Maybe let's finally get into the game. Regarding the oil, yeah, peanut or canola would be better because olive oil burns at a lower temperature. Really? Oh, I didn't know that. It's good to know. Do you shape them and cook them or store them? Yeah, I shape them and cook them. I don't store it. I freeze a lot of my meat and then I'll take it out a couple days before. So that way it's thawed, and then that night I'll get it out, I'll season it, I'll shape it, and then I'll cook it. So it isn't sitting around for too long. But yeah, chat, let's go to the game. I forgot to actually set up my game, so one second. I'm excited to get back into this game. We haven't played it in so long. There's been quite a many updates since we last played it. Alright, chat, let's switch over. Whoop! Wah! Ta-da! Press any button. Oh, okay. Displays as the artist intended. Oh. Still screen. Yeah, we want pixel perfect. Go 70 maybe? 65? We'll see if that's good. And English. Oh, that should be good then. I want to try making a smash burger. What is a smash burger? I've never heard of that before. Choo choo! To burger you smash flat. Wait. Like the whole thing? Or just the patty? Like they're really thin, so like you take the whole burger and then you like smash it down into like a sandwich size? Or is it just a really thin patty? I assume it's the first one, but I don't see how it would be any different from a normal burger. I think usually the patty. I think I accidentally make smash burgers then. Because I feel like my patties are a little thin. I don't know though. Could probably be thinner. Could also be a lot bigger though too. Let's see. All right. I wonder where the carrot was. Carrot? You're still thinking about that? Found everything except the carrot. The one I saw, they cooked the onion, then put the meat on top and mushed it into it, then also added the cheese on top, all on the grill. I would be worried about smushing my meat on top of something on a grill. Just, I assume they had like a flat top grill, while mine has the little, I don't know what they're called, grill grates. So I can't smush things on my grill. It would fall into the yucky underside and would be inedible. But I do also have a you can set a normal oven tray on the grates. Yucky underside. Yeah, the yucky underside. I barely learned how to grill. You think I know much of how to clean it? Especially the bottom part. I'm afraid of the bottom part, chat. The bottom part scares me. I barely know how to turn the grill on and use it. I have cleaned the grates before, but besides that, no idea what's going on at all. I have no idea. We just pray. We pray for the grill. Sometimes it catches on fire. That's kind of scary. We love the bottom part. No, we don't. The bottom part is scary. Oh, what I was saying, I have a thing for my stove that kind of does that. It's like a really big piece of metal, and it's essentially supposed to act like a hibachi grill top, and it's for like regular stoves and stuff. It's pretty neat. I like it. Haven't used it in a while though. Maybe I should use it soon. Found everything except the carrot. I think it's good that we never found the carrot. There was something off about that legendary carrot soup recipe. Just realized we never checked the men's restroom. You actually have some shame? Thought you knew nothing but adventures. We searched the whole school safe for that place, but we never found the carrot. That means the carrot was in the men's restroom. Carrot in the men's restroom? What an odd sense of humor. I should write Jenny a letter asking her to look through the men's restroom. Can't you ask Will instead? It's the men's restroom after all. Nope, that coward finds it, he'll take it to the professor bawling like before. Keep in mind that if it weren't for Will, he'd be in jail right now instead of on a train. Or 6 feet under. Ugh, so bored. I never noticed her hat has a tear in it. That's interesting. Flashback. Flashbacks are supposed to be boring. I see why no one wanted to ride this god-awful train. It's boring enough to drive anyone insane. Ticket for this train costs 500 pies. And it stopped the witch's house in Highland, where all roads lead to. Your magna cum laude at school for witches. Whatever, I don't care about any of that. How did I become magna cum laude anyway? I even sneaked into the forbidden principal's office twice. Three times. I looked through the forbidden books in the hidden library in the school basement. I still remember that horned rabbit that was as big as a house. Good afternoon, gamers. Hello, Moontide. Welcome and good to see you. Happy July 4th. You put a pixel filter on, you look right at home in this game, Griffin. Oh, wait, how do I do that? Hello, Jittery! Welcome and good to see you! Oh shoot, wait, Huh! Why did I change color? Oh, I look so blurry right here. Oh. Why do I look so blurry? Okay, full filter. Color filter off. Wait, color filter on, maybe? Just a little bit? Oh, heck yeah. Is that better? You can't really tell. Oh, wait. Oh, that's too much. Oh, that's too much. Huh? Ow, 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 ow. I just look crunchy now. Fry. What is fry? Oh my goodness. Ah! Ah! Not that. Not that at all. Do not fry the griffin. Ow, 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 ow. Terrific! Welcome in, good to see you! Hope you're having a wonderful day. Alright, there we go, chat. I have pixels now. My pixels have pixels. Hope you're having a wonderful 4th of July. Let's see. Oh, Dark! Welcome in! Happy 4th of July too! Hope you're having a wonderful day. Let's see. Alright, we're on the next dialogue. No wonder Will started crying. So how on earth did I manage Magna Cum Laude? Simply didn't want to lose. Let it out and sit quietly. This is a train only for those who want to succeed. The witch's house might be dark and damp, but it's only 3 years of your life. Fine. Enough with the lecture. The thought of taking off my shoes when I got off the train alone was disturbing enough. Shoes? For what? You've just arrived and you're already planning to get us into trouble? I won't fool around the moment I get there. I didn't know you had self-control. Don't you know about the terrible city of rules that is High Lion? The first thing to do here is take your shoes off as soon as you get off the train. This is my first time hearing something like that. Heard that Jenny's older sister was wearing tall lace-up boots when she first arrived at High Lion, so she almost couldn't get off because she was busy untying the boots. See, Mom bought me new shoes as well. Didn't Arya just mean to encourage you? No, Dad also did say that comfortable boots would be better. That's strange. It's true. Ask someone else if you don't believe me. Okay. Well, shoot, chat. Oh, didn't mean to do whatever that is. Hello, Mr. Bartender. Hey, wanna drink? Wait, I'm gonna... Turn my pixels up just a bit more, I look a little blurry. Uh-huh. Better. No, I don't drink alcohol. Do you have any tea? Of course. I'll have a cup of that. Tea has alcohol, though. Is that okay? But then that's just alcohol! Alcohol with tea! Potato, potato. Then, can I ask you a question instead of a drink? Anytime. Okay. Want some water? Does the water have alcohol in it? We only sell alcohol at the moment. Okay. What sort of work do you do here? I'm mixing my life and changing the alcohol. Wait, I think it's the other way around. Just an average bartender working in the most expensive place in the world. Brinji is very expensive trained. Thought you were listening to our conversation. I stopped listening when it got boring. I'm gonna be an apprentice at the witch's house in Highland. After working as an apprentice for 3 years, I'll be able to graduate from the school for witches. Wow, Highland, huh? It's a busy place, isn't it? So they say. It's probably why you got the train ticket for free. You must be someone special. I don't really care about that kind of thing, though. That kind of thing is what's important at the end of the day. It's best to just suck it up. You'll be glad you did later down the road, you know. Yeah, later. I've never heard of it. Okay. He keeps trying to give us water when he doesn't even have water! Let me know if you need anything to drink. Okay. Oh, hey. Can you take a look at my shoes? Your shoes? What for? From what I've heard, you have to take your shoes off before you step foot into Highline Station. You work at the train, so you know what I'm talking about, right? Oh, that story. Alright, I've seen plenty of confused passengers who were all dressed up for Highline, only to find themselves in the wrong shoes. If you're wearing shoes of that sort, I'd advise you to untie them in advance. Oh, ye who reacheth Highline, look first upon thy shoes. Or so that's how the saying goes. See, Virgil, I was right. These slip-on boots Mom gave me tell me just as much. Those are some nice boots. Right? Mom bought them for me when she found out I was graduating magna cum laude. Sure is amazing you're graduating magna cum laude despite your antics. You gonna keep up with that attitude of yours? Ha, hearing the two of you speak, I have a feeling that boredom won't be an issue. Nope, it's so boring. Aren't you bored, Mr. Bartender? I've gotten used to it. It's certainly gone less boring, thanks to your chat with your hat. You've been listening? Other passengers would have all heard about your arson at the school for witches by now, if there were any. I didn't set it on fire. Really? Sure, there was a fire, but that was because I shook a potion 5 times and made it explode. Potions must be shaken 3 times only. Even a non-witch like me knows that. Exactly. How can you not try shaking it 4 times having heard that? But you said you shook it 5 times. Nothing happened on the 4th time, so I shook it once more. An inquisitive mind. You've already got the makings of a fine witch. Thanks for the praise. I wasn't praising you. I should be on my way then. Alright, have a fun trip. Can't act like a country bumpkin once you're in the city, got it? You're not going to ask just one person, are you? Why? Whatever research you do, one sample is never enough, you know. Not even the greatest detectives can reach the truth based on a single piece of evidence. You have a point. Hello, Vogon! Hello, Zeal Poser! Welcome in, welcome in! Hope we're both having a wonderful July 4th! Hello, hello! Psycho main character moment? Yep. Okay, we need to ask the otter person? And I assume the dog. Hello, Heaven! Good to see you! Happy Canada Day! That was a few days ago, but yes, Happy Canada Day! Happy America Day, too. Oh, big wrist pop. Up ahead's the engine room. Shop. Do, do, do. I'm an attendant of Brightman Railroads. My job is to ensure the passengers' comfort and safety. Okay, he really doesn't want to talk to us. We don't check the passenger's outfit. Even if you don't check, it's inconvenient to get off if you wear lace-up boots. There are so many different types of clothing that cause discomfort. I can't define them all. Then, what are you having a hard time taking off your shoes? Then, what about having a hard time taking off your shoes when you get off? Delays occur once in a while due to their shoes, but again, it's not regulated. Guess there's no fine? Isn't it a matter of harming social reputation rather than the fine? Is that so? Okay. Ramen sounds so good. Oh my goodness. Hello. Oh wait, chat. I'm gonna move a little bit. That way you can see the people. There we go. Hopefully that's better. Just in a bad place. Can't be anywhere near the bottom because I'll block the dialogue, I'll block our character, I'll block the other character. We might move into the other corner, we'll see. Oh, hello. Am I disturbing you? Negative. What's the issue? Oh, I want to ask you something. You're on the way to Highline, right? Correct. What's the matter? Oh, it's just that you have a very rigid way of speaking. Oh my. Old habits die hard, especially when it's deep in thought. You sound like the janitor from my school. Well, I used to be a soldier. So, what brings you here? Speak. Oh, thank you for that, Pats! Also, welcome in, Gremlin, welcome in, Shadow Prince. They're both here. I hope you are both having a wonderful July 4th. Hello, hello. Wait, is this that Chucklefish game? Chucklefish game? I don't think so. Before that, what? You've been staring at my feet for a while. Is there some kind of problem? Oh, I was going to ask anyway. Isn't it troublesome to wear such strappy boots? Takes some time to put them on and take them off, but I'm used to it. Then it would be hard for you when you arrive at Highland. What? What are you talking about? I mean, you have to take your shoes off when you get off. What? 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 Huh? Oh, you were kidding? I'm sorry, I'm rather dull when it comes to things like this. Jenny? Mr. Bartender? At last, mystery solved. Some kind of mistake. No, I just realized that I was deceived. Come to think of it, I remember now. It's a joke to make fun of people who visit Highline for the first time. Stop. You don't have to kill me twice by giving me that much detail. I'm sorry. Are you holding back laughter? No, I'm not. He's trying so hard to be considerate of you. Don't ask twice. Virgil, I hate you even more now. You don't need to be too upset. But I was there for the first time in the past. I was also tricked by a colleague and took them off. That doesn't comfort me at all. I'm sorry. How do you feel? What do you mean? Your molars might fall out. Relax a bit when you speak. I can't believe Jenny deceived me. There's a reason why she's your friend. Now go back to your seat quietly and wait until we've arrived. I still have 3 more days to go. 3 more days? That's as terrible as the smell of spotted shiitake mushrooms. Oh, that's which book? Never mind. I think it has a similar looking main character. Oh, I knew it was called Witch Book, but I don't recall the main character. I am excited for it though, whenever it may come out. Alright. Have some patience and stay seated. Ugh. I'm bored. But you just sat down. This is torture. Should have torn up that stupid ticket right then and there. Check out this idiotic patterning. Looks like it has armpit feathers of a phoenix in it. Although not from the armpit, definitely has phoenix feather. It definitely has phoenix feather phoenix? Huh? It's rare of people from counterfeiting such expensive tickets. You're such a know-it-all. No one asked. If I should ask something, it'd be about the mountain right outside there. It must be hiding a cave with a tiled chamber deep within. There'd be tall pillars, strange statues, and a giant door. In front of it you'll find... Sounds like prologue to a story where you awaken a terrible demon. Wait, hold on. Virgil, shut up and look at the window! The summit of the mountain! There's a gigantic shining tree. A gigantic shining tree! Why is it shining? Does it have luminous flowers? It must be beautiful up close. Give it up. This train won't stop for 2 days. Ugh. I want to get out now. Also, yes, if anyone wants to follow my Twitter, join my Discord, check out my YouTube, Twitch, or Throne. There are all my links in chat and the rest are my card. I hope we crash. Bad chance of that happening. So stay bored. Carl, you signed up for the 3 years of even more boredom. Aren't there any crocophants nearby? Nope. What about boa constrictors? This isn't a jungle. Train robbers? This isn't the Wild West. It's a healing game, remember? Hey, a boa constrictor. The correct line is, what's going on? Psycho moment number two. Oh no, it's a pattern. There's no station here. Why are we stopping? I'm not sure. Maybe there's something wrong with the train. That's a boa constrictor, though. I don't care if it's not a boa constrictor. Please just say there's some massively critical issue. Please, 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 please. We apologize for the inconvenience. Critical issue, perhaps? The train cannot continue its journey due to a critical issue. Yes! Attention, the train will stop until tomorrow morning. And the departure time? Can we go outside? Will likely be announced tomorrow. We will depart immediately if possible. Okay, I'll be back in a bit. In the meantime, please avoid wandering too far from the train. Let's go! Not sure if you remember, but... Of course I remember the shining trees at the peak. No, not that. We have to get back by tomorrow morning. And we should get going. Wow, it's so dark. If you're scared, we can go back to the train. I love it. Let's hurry. She's gonna lose the train and that's how she becomes a little witch in the woods, isn't it? I don't know, you'll have to stay and find out. Wait, what did the memo board say? Oh, ah. It's a hill. It won't be easy to climb. Look over there. There are vines hanging on the hill. I'll be able to climb that much. It's bad news. Parkour! Parkour! It's a secret passageway, Virgil! I don't think it's a secret or a passageway. But there's a path beyond here. What's this? Looks like little honey pumpkin. What's that? It's demon that grows in gardens. The vines grow so fast that you can never get rid of them by hand. To remove the vines, you must find and destroy the core hidden somewhere. If we find the core, we can remove the vines, right? Or just be good and return to the train. That can't happen. Let's go look for the core. It must be nearby. Since the core gives off light when you touch the vines, you'll be able to find it. Meow. Ba-doop. Oh, they died. Okay, I tried to pick them. Great, it's finally time to explore! Please don't use that word, explore. That word gives me anxiety, thanks to your mother. Shining trees at the peak of the mountain, so go quickly if you want to see it. Must return to the train by tomorrow morning. Yeah, yeah. Gonna turn this down just a touch. If she doesn't make it back to the train, it'll be with pockets full of sticks and berries. Heck yeah. Might have been a little too low. There we go. What's this? Witch flower? Shining trees at the peak of the mountain. Just go quickly if you want to see it. Stop yelling at me, Mr. Hat. Trees at the peak of the mountain, blah blah blah. Here's a village, Virgil. You should go to Highline. What a shame. Oh. Goodbye. Yeah, Sari's pretty good. Orby shot at me, chat. Help. So it seems like we can't pick those. Thank you. a mountain. Really? Because you hate it, right? Always hated mountains. My leather gets worn out from all the wind. Golly, welcome in, welcome in. I hope we're having a wonderful day. Sorry, chat, you'd have decided to come in here and shoot me with an Orbi gun. Got done playing a horror game? Ooh. What horror game? Grab all of this stuff over here. Sucks we don't have a bug catcher. Outlast 2, I got past tutorial like a big boy. Good job! Outlast is pretty scary. Let's go this way. Oh, there's more. Stamina! Aw, heck, chat. Oh, hey. The only thing I'm gonna outlast is my own sanity. Wouldn't be too sure about that. Alright, well, we can't pick anything, chat. We need to go up to the mountain. Wasted all my stamina. Why are there so many things blocking the path? This must be a forest with many secrets. What's this? It's like a barrier made with a witch sigil. Witch sigil? Is there a witch here? There was, or... Do you remember how it works? School hammered it into my head. Should be an issue as long as it's drawn well. Alright, let's see. Guess we go this way? Or not? Chalk for that one, okay. Wow, it's the shining tree. The same one we saw from the train. This is a bitter grape tea tree. I don't think the tree is the one that's shining. Check this out, Virgil. There are a ton of butterflies on it. You're right, the butterflies seem to be glowing. These are blue moon butterflies. They give off a subtle moonlight. The light from these butterflies has the same power as actual moonlight. That's why strange things always happen in their habitat. They change the environment. Aren't they beautiful? Giant tea tree with butterflies glowing with moonlight. It's not just beautiful. It could be called an amazing sight to behold. Is this a pretty magnificent discovery? Actually, those two life forms are not rare themselves. What? You mean although the sight is stunning, it's not special? The fact that those two are together is the amazing part. What about those two being together? Usually raised together artificially to get moonflower in Loserine or two. It's uncommon for them to be together naturally like this. Anyway, we did find something, right? I guess so. I have to write a letter to the school. Let's look around a bit more. Pull up the encyclopedia and all, right? Just don't be late. I must return to the train tomorrow morning. Okay, let's go back the way we came. Might be other strange things. I don't think I'll get a wink of sleep on the train. I wonder if there's anywhere I can sleep for tonight. What about the ground? The dirt and rocks should make for a nice bed. That's not funny, Virgil. Look, this place is also inhabited by the Blue Moon Butterfly we saw at the peak. Might as well collect some for study purposes. Oh, think I could just sneak up and grab it? Wait, don't you remember what Mr. Gravier said? Death lives under the bed? No, not that. Draw it before you touch it. Exactly. Firstly, use the quill to draw it in the encyclopedia. Scroll down before you can use the quill on something of this type again. Open encyclopedia. Draw it before you touch it. So people know what kills you when they find your dead body? Exactly. Drawing life forms with the quill in the encyclopedia unlocks info about them. Locked info can be unlocked by drawing another organism of the same type that has not been drawn using it. Habitat, time of appearance, etc. Tools for collecting. Collected item. How to make collecting easier. You may level up your encyclopedia and receive rewards by pulling off different actions. Collect when sitting, collect when flying, draw unique objects with a quill. Ah. Exit. Great, so I just turned in the encyclopedia. Let's see. Now do you see why you can't catch any? Tool. You can collect them using a bug net. I don't have one right now, though. Not much you can do, then. I want to do it right now! Getting to the witch's house in Highline is more important. Let's go back down now. There's gotta be something else that's fun. Draw the flower. Oh, okay. No! There we go, okay. Want to draw this one right here. No, not fire! Dang it. I like the music in this game. It's nice chat. Oh, wow. Ellie, let's go back to the train. Look at that, Virgil. A shiny white cat. Never seen anything like it before. Ellie, we have to... Let's go after that creature. Shake. Drop this silly little thing. Ta-da! Draw the flower. Oh, what's this? I think the cat dropped something. What is it? Like a white chalk. The thing used to draw sigils? It's a little different from the one we were using at school. Just different packaging. This witch sigil seems to have been erased a bit. It won't work if it gets erased like this. You can draw the sigil again using the same colored white chalk. Since I have the one I picked up earlier, let's draw it again with that. Should I redraw the witch sigil using one? Yes. Redrawn it. Follow that cat, chat. Huh? Where'd the cat go? Look, Virgil, there's a house! That's a witch's house, isn't it? Looks pretty old. Guess we can talk to the master witch here and stay here for a while. Doesn't look like there are people inside. Hello, Leon! Welcome and welcome and good to see you! Hope we're having a wonderful day. There's no one. Might stay for a while. Isn't it natural for an apprentice witch to stay at a witch's house? It's true, but... Anyone there? Is anyone there? Seems like no one's here. Witch's house may have been abandoned. After all, even the Witch Administration can miss out things. Alright, let's go inside! Oh, really is an abandoned witch's house. Taking that in consideration, it looks okay. Although, it's not that clean. Since the witch's house is managed on her own, it doesn't seem to be in a very good condition considering how dirty it is. That looks comfortable though, right? Guess I can just sleep here. Looked bigger on the outside? It did. Well, since the witch's house is a public institution, it's okay to sleep one night or so. It's better than sleeping outside. Guess we can't clean it, chat. Is the witch Griffin Newskin too? What? I don't understand. But I hope you're having a wonderful day, Leon. Hello, hello. What's that face? You slept on a nice, fluffy bed. Yes, but I dreamt that I was sleeping on the train. What effort not to sleep on the train only to dream of just that? You should have slept on the train. No, that's not it. I slept very well, actually. I can almost hear the sound of the train, though. Wait, isn't that indeed the sound of the train? What, really? Is it departing already? Let's go have a look. Really is the sound of the train whistle. I think it's about to leave. Let's hurry back. Woke up just in time. Thought I didn't sleep in. Meow. Gotta hurry, chat. It's gonna leave us. Oh wait, first we gotta grab the plant. Oh, or not. Grab the plant! Hello, Joe! Welcome and thank you so much for the resub! Hello, hello!
13.
Have a wonderful day. 13! Happy 4th of July! Lucy Fangs as well. Happy 4th of July! Hope you're both having a wonderful day. Run, 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 run. We gotta run, chat. Ah! Choo choo. Huh? Where's the train? Ah, looks like that bird was imitating train whistle sounds. Alert, but thank you so much for the lurk, Joe. Thank you. Where's the train? It's gone to Highline, of course. What do we do now? Let's look around the area. We may find some clues. Why are you so calm? Been through much worse with your mom. Parkour! Choo choo. What on earth is that thing? It's called the Gaga Bird. They say it's a bit insane. Quiet. I don't need this information now. Sure fault for oversleeping. Don't blame the Gaga Bird. Fine, whatever, just be quiet. Oh, hey. A letter! How nice of them to leave a letter behind. Let's see, things from the bartender on the train. You're probably shocked to see that the train is gone. Heard that a witch who arrived in the middle of the night got rid of the prickly vines in no time. Fortunately, the train couldn't wait any longer and had to leave right away. Don't worry, the train will come back, and there's a village nearby where I used to live. You can just spend some time there. There should be a sign in the forest. Follow it and find the village. When you arrive at the village, please send Unite and Arden my regards. Bartender. Place I saw earlier must be the village. I've been a little upset that we missed the train, Ellie. It's okay since there's a village, right? Guess we can just wait here. How about cleaning the witch's house? You never know what might happen. Check if there really is a village. Okay. Please try not to sound so excited. We missed the train, remember? Okay. You heard me, right? Well then, I might as well add more to the encyclopedia now. Nothing there? Okay. Can't chase after the bird. So I can't draw these bushes, apparently. Whoa, what's over here? Oh, I can't go that way, okay. Oh, look at them. Wait, collection tool hand. Aha! What were those time thingies? Time thingies? Time thingies? They had like four. Oh, that's the time before I can draw them again in my book. The ink is still drying. Oh, grab it! There we go. Aha! Oh, there's a yellow one! Wait! There's a yellow one right here. We haven't seen a yellow flower. That's not Animal Crossing kind of IRL time based? Yeah, no. That would be awful. Let's get rid of the weeds first. There's too much. Take forever to pull all this out using hands. Take a look at the bin over there. I contain a potion to get rid of weeds. Bin. The bin. I like binging my games, thank you very much. Yeah, same. There's nothing here. Then we'll have to use another tool. Is there another tool? Yes, there's a wonderful tool. What's that? Your hands. Oh. Well, heck, chat. Just like Minecraft has taught us. Any other? Oh, that's no weed. What was that? It left something behind. A rich ring. Rich ring? That's a cute name. How is it buried there? Someone could have buried it, or it could have been sleeping. I have to be more specific than that. There's not much that's known about rich rings. Well, other than good fortune if you find one? Yeah, I guess it did leave behind a gift of sorts. I just bought them while you're wandering around. Okay, I'll look for more. Now, if only I knew what it actually looked like, because I couldn't see anything right there. Ooh! Clean up. Clean up. Alright, I think that's all. It's clean now. Good. Now it's time to tidy up the house. Right. I don't remember this being here before. Ooh, that's new. Look, Ellie, it's a quest mark. All I see is dust and cobwebs that we have to clean up. Exactly what I'm talking about. Let's find something useful while cleaning. Oh, it's a notebook. Might be useful later. This house is such a mess. Oh, so hello! Come in, good to see you! Yeah, you can call me Griffy. Cute game. Yeah, it is July 4th today, America Day. I'm gonna hear all of the fireworks tonight. I already started hearing some last night. It's like, no, can you at least wait till tomorrow? Your room was cleaner than this. You're right, if it's the dust that you're talking about. Boop. The witch bookshelf. Technically, it's a bookshelf that a witch once used. That's the same as a witch bookshelf. I'm not going to read a book, though. I'm tired of books. Even a poisonous mushroom is better than a witch who doesn't read books. What does that mean? So are we squatters rightsing this house? Yes, we are. Because a poisonous mushroom kills just one person. Stop nagging. I read enough books at school. 12 plants that change the history of witches. Fun witch plant encyclopedia. Dream plants for witch garden. There's so many books on plants. I guess the previous resident was a witch who studied plants. Should store any books I get in here. I wonder where the previous witch went. She probably left a long, long time ago. She can be living well somewhere in Lucerne or two. All done cleaning! It's also messy in front of the desk over there, Ellie, in case you didn't notice. Stop bossing me around like a professor! Finally managed to get out of school. There's some dust over there, Ellie. Don't leave food behind, Ellie. Told you not to go inside the principal's office, Ellie. You should have listened. Oh, this is a witch elevator. That's why you should listen to your professors. Let's hurry up and go down. What if there's a scary monster? You think so? Oh, I'm so excited. That's what we call self-gaslighting. Meow. Ta-da! Wow, look at this, Virgil. This looks like the dispensary. You can make potions here as long as you've got the proper tools. But I need some cleaning first. Wow. Cleaning again. I know what this is. It's an extractor. We used it so many times at school. It's a slightly smaller one, though. It'd be hard to use. Look at the glass bottle underneath. Oh, that's true. It's broken. Need a friendly toad, at least. Need to get a glass bottle first in order to use this. You need to at least fix the extractor in order to make potions. Alright, let's go to the village first. Let's look for one. Hello, Noodle Soup! Welcome in, welcome in, good to see you! Hope you're having a wonderful 4th of July! Squishy chub fur extract. Bush bug extract. Why is this sitting here? Wish flower extract. This is a potion ingredient, isn't it? Used them in school countless times. Which is usually this sloppy? I mean, you have a happy 4th of July. Canada Day was on the 1st. Well, I hope you had an amazing Canada Day! Never heard of this, but it looks awesome. Yeah, I really like the art style for this. It's very nice. Sloppy or not, they're careful with their ingredients. I guess the witch that lived here was really sloppy. Or she left in a hurry. Why? Beats me. Spilt bottle. Scribbled paper in a book? What a mess. Just brush off the dust. Just brushing off the dust might take a lifetime. What's this? Moon oil? Looks like a recipe for a potion. Judging from the mark, this should be a limited recipe. Feels like if they made a sweet Sega 32X JRPG, the graphics not... Like, not quite 16-bit, not quite 32-bit, yeah. You don't see any tile set kind of art. It all seems to be hand-placed individually. Very true, yeah. It's very nice. The witch recipes are also disposable. Guess it was used by the witch who was here. Reads, a potion with the power of moon. The ingredients are moonflower and phoenix feather. They're all very expensive. Maybe it's someday. Let's have it ready for now. Yep, alright. There's also something underneath. Where? Oh, you're right. What kind of text this is? Learned it at school. It's the ancient witch language. You mean I learned how to read these strange symbols? Your score wasn't bad either. I don't remember anything. Anyway, let's have a look first. Looks like a recipe. Seems like moons something. I have no idea. I got a headache. Take a look if you remember later. should put it away and revisit it later. The desk would be nice to use a workbench later. No use for it now, though. Lots of stuff, chat. Also, lots of reading. Oh my goodness. True, every pile of books is unique. Very true. Right, the difference between art and design. Love it. Heck yeah. A roaster? Oh, I hate this thing. If you put in the collected items, it's a long and anxious wait. It's quite convenient as long as you remember to toss the collected items in beforehand. It seems to be in bad condition. Really? Oh, yeah. There's no handle for winding the spring. Why'd I get a roaster handle? It's okay. The roaster's not needed for the basic recipes. We may find something in the village. Yeah, let's go to the village first. Oh, everything here's broken. Can't expect to find things intact in a place so dirty and messy. I feel like you usually can. This box looks pretty useful. Could put stuff in here when my pockets are full. Speaking of. What is this? What is this? Giant branch? Okay. Wow, this pot looks really good. I think it was made by the Blue Lightning Workshop, and it has a very classic design. I've only ever used the cheap pots at school. Finally, I get to use a good one. Do you remember how to use one? Of course. Use processed ingredients, heat them precisely, and stir them in the right direction. And at last you'll end up with a proper potion. Do you like Harry Potter at all when you were a kid, or if you still do as an adult? Yeah, I really liked Harry Potter. Looks very hot tubable, it does, it's very large. I actually like the way Miss Olivia speaks. Still, the cauldron looks fine. You'll be able to make a potion if you have the ingredients. Processing tools are in a bad condition, though. Since there are some discarded ingredients, let's make the potion we need using them now. All done cleaning. We can make potions. Only half of this stuff remains, so you can't process. Let's try making some of the stuff we picked up earlier. Why? What do you mean, why? Why not? I ask because people usually have reasons. Alright. Progress bar at the top indicates quality of the potion. If you don't follow the instructions, ball is shortened. Bar disappears, crafting fails. Longer the remaining bar when you finish, the higher the score. Displayed on the right's the recipe of the potion currently being crafted. Complete all phases. Without failing. During the fire setting phase, you should adjust the heat intensity as required. You just need to follow the recipe's instructions. During the ladle phase, adjust the ladle's direction. Adding ingredients, you must add the required ingredients. Okay. Encounter unexpected situations in both the fire setting phase and the ladle direction phase. Handle the unexpected situations, make high quality potions. Okay. Let's see. Did you ever see the Game Boy Color JRPG, the first and second books / movies? There's such an interesting take on it, almost like the Lord of the Rings JRPG. I did not. Also, welcome back, Shadow B. That's so good to hear. Burger, let's go. This is almost like Atelier games. Okay, let's do it, chat. What do we got? Wishbug. Oh, witch flower. There we go. Oh, I sent the pic early. If I send it again, Griffin may end me. It's okay. You can send it. I just won't look at it this time. Hello? Ah, there we go. Weed Terminator Potion. Manual craft. Yeah, it was at the beginning of Stream Noodle. Okay. So... select ingredients. We need this. And we need this. Okay. Oh my god. Right? It looks like a great burger. Y'all appreciate your hard work, Griffin? Oh, thank you, Zoe. I appreciate it. Is there a mouse cursor we can't see? Are you doing this all with the keyboard? I'm doing it all with the keyboard. That is a big burger. It is a big burger. Awesome. The stubborn weed extermination potion is complete. It's extermination, not externization. Anyway, it's ready. Let's look for the village for now. Choose it carefully since there are no more ingredients. Okay, don't worry. Throw it at the little honey pumpkin and find the vine core and remove it. Because the weed terminator potion is just a temporary measure. Got it. Alright. Let's go chat. Jesus, that looks just the sheen on the bun. I know my skin would look like that after eating it. A hot dang. Do my salivary glands want to go hard in the paint? Putting boba in the picture. You sure like to live dangerously? Oh, I didn't even notice the boba. Oh, we can save and load. Yeah, I didn't notice the boba. I was looking at the burger the whole time. I'm gonna start a restaurant chain someday for burgers and boba? Heck yeah. Save. Now take naps. Cannot take naps at night. You can only take one nap per day. What? Why do you limit me to one per day? Imagine only getting to take one nap per day, chat. Oh, what a sad life. I also look up the Widowmaker Burgery from Claim Jumpers. Oh, Widowmaker Burger. The thing is massive. Oh my goodness. How many naps do you take? Now I gotta ask. Like, after you say that, your avatar just kind of looks like she's falling asleep slowly. And I'm always yawning too. Alright, so I assume I do like this. Here it goes. I think it's working. Find the core! Pick up the core! Yeah. Heck yeah. I take as many naps as I want to take a day. Though I usually don't need any naps because I use them all during my sleep. Huh? This isn't a village. Look over there, Ellie. It's a prickly vine this time. It's quite huge and thick. Oh no. What do I do with the extractor? First, take a look around it. Oh, look at the big old guy. Look at him. Child, look at him. He's taking a nappy nap. Hello, do you live in the village? Wow, what a lovely view. I wish I could stop, like, blocking everyone. We'll go right here. What? Aren't these trees beautiful? The green leaves are so pretty in the sun. Oh, sure. Nature's so breathtaking. must love nature a lot. Suppose no one dislikes nature since it's so charming. I'm the main character now. Oh, yeah, right. Exactly. Perfect. Okay, I'll be back. I'm the main character now. Walk under the vast sky and feel the charm of nature. I was an enthusiastic fan of nature. So enthusiastic that you can't have a proper conversation with her. You should respect her interests. In my head, Kenny Griffin's always been its way for Bullock asleep unless we keep her engaged. That is, not untrue. It's more of an obsession. Something didn't feel right about her. Think she's cursed or something? Curse that makes her praise nature all the time? Cursed by a nature lover? Well, maybe. I'll think of it that, Pets. Many witches are quirky after all. Right, just slowly sinking her little into her little cappuccino hot tub cup. Heck yeah. Curse lifting candy that can lift the curse should be among the basic recipes. Griffin the OPOC. We can't use the processing tool now. Let's process what's been collected to make potions. What do I do? Picked up several ingredients at the workplace earlier, didn't you? Those would be enough to make curse lifting candy. Did you see the thing beside them? Beside them what? There's a glass bottle that would be perfect as a glass extractor bottle. Where? There really is! Alright, let's make curse lifting candy lift the curse. To receive that glass bottle as a reward. That'd be nice. First, let's check on the candy that can lift the curse in the encyclopedia. So we need a yellow thingy and a white thingy, which I think we got at the basement. Okay. Hello? Oh, it's forcing me to go look at it. Wow, it's really big. Too big for the Wii Terminator potion, I think. Need another solution. Okay, there. Hopefully it'll let me leave now. Do, 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 do. Pick up stick. Oh. Badoop. Gonna go make curse lifting candy. Ba-dump, ba-dump, ba-dump. Okay, three. Boop. Oh wait, wrong way! Oh man, I almost messed that up real bad. Only a 77! Oh, I don't remember crafting scores being a thing before. I'm so bad! Okay, let's go chat. Oh wait, 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 wait. I forgot something. No? What? What? There's a broom here and I can't use it? Okay, whatever. I could have sworn we could pick it up. I guess not. That's stinky. Shall I give her the curse lifting candy? I guess. Would you like to try this? May the blessings of nature be with you. Hello? Yes, hello. Am I speaking properly now? Yes, I think so. Wow, thank you so much. To hell with nature. Because there really was a curse. An old man in the jungle was to hear. He was apparently suspicious. Simply couldn't ignore such a well-made wooden statue of a monkey. After I bought it, I could only talk about praising nature. Tried to speak sarcastically or write, but all that came out were praises for nature. Pure torture. Hope nature just rots and dies. Still, I'm glad the curse was easily removed. Oh, thank you so much. My name is Aurea. How long has it been since I said my name? My name is Ellie. I'm an apprentice witch. Oh, did you come to this village to be an apprentice? I was on a train, but I got off for a moment and it left without me. Oh dear. I wanted to enter the village, but it was blocked up by some prickly vines. Dang nature! Thankfully, we found an empty witch's house nearby, so I've been staying there. Empty? Oh yeah, there's a witch house here. That's good. I have business in this village too, but the vine stopped me. Nature be damned. Be here for a while, so let me know if you need anything. Griffin is a witch. What's your favorite element of magic? I like ice. Ooh. That's a tough one. Depends. What elements are there to choose from? Oh, then can I ask you a favor? Not a favor, but a fair price. What do you need? Tools are broken when I was trying to use the dispensary at the witch's house. Do you have any tools or parts? What kind of tools or parts do you need? I need a glass bottle for the extractor and a roaster handle for winding the roaster. Wait a minute, I'll look for them. Sure. But Ellie, do you have any money? I do. Mom gave me pocket money when I came out. Think you'll be able to buy witch tools with just enough pocket money to buy a snack or two? Is that so? What if I don't have enough money? Since you have tools, make and sell potions or something. You can also sell candies now. Only if there are people to buy them. I'm back. Here you are. Oh. How much is this? Oh, never mind. This is my return for breaking my curse. Wow, thank God. Fortunately, I don't have any roaster handle for a roaster. I see. Will you be staying at the village? If so, I'll bring it next time. Charge you for it then, however. Could please bring it then. Okay, I'll write roaster handle in the memo. I want to take this too. Since the worth of the bottle earlier wasn't enough, I'll give this to you as well. What is this? It's an atlas, including maps of the surroundings. It's not complete. Please find time to fill in the missing parts. To have a map, you need to draw it. Find the map sign somewhere in the region and draw a map. I've included maps of the surroundings. You can check them out later. I almost got lost. Thank you. To repay the medicine fee you gave me. No need to thank me. Oh. This is a bonus. Now you can thank me. Alright, thank you. Sure, looking forward to your next visit. Now we're finally able to fix the extractor. Are you really going to stay in this village? I shut until the train comes. Really? I have no choice. No, I mean, are you really going to leave when the train comes? Well, I'll decide when it does come. Let's just fix the extractor first. Well, there's plenty to choose from. Classic fire, water, earth, and air. There's stuff like lightning, nature, light, dark, loads of others. That's a tough one.
Grab it.
Joshua, thank you so much for the follow. Thank you, thank you. Hope you're having a wonderful day. No, it left. Heck. We lost it, chat. Oh, wait. Ah! I don't know, I'd have to think about it. So let's see, fire could always be useful. So could water. Earth, I feel like it could be helpful, though not as often. Air, again, always useful. Nature would be useful. Light and darkness, that could also be useful. Let's see. I would probably say... Oh, lightning would also be really fun, but I don't know if it'd be any useful. Earth for the civil engineer witch, water for the fishing fish. Does the element of laughter count? Perhaps. Lightning for the fishing witch. No, water for the fishing witch. We don't shock the fish. I would say I would probably either go... Ooh, nature or... nature or water. Nature or water. I think. Probably nature. Well, thank you for the headbands. Oh, we have nothing. Okay. Let's fix our thingy. Remove the vines. That's true, but it seems impossible to get rid of that huge thing with the recipes I have now. Now the extractor's fixed, you'll be able to make potions with basic recipes. You make weed terminator potion, you can get rid of the little honey pumpkin. I'll chime in and enjoy darkness punctuated by explosions utilizing air and fire. Oh my goodness, that sounds really cool. I would say, I think I would lean more towards nature, but storm seems like it would be really cool. Water/ice would be pretty cool. I didn't mean to make that pun, I'm sorry. and fire is always pretty cool. But I would probably go nature. And then, if I could subclass, I would go either water or light. Probably water, so that way I could water my plants. Or light, so that way I don't need to worry about my plants getting enough light. But probably... nature and then water. Though fire is pretty cool. Fire's pretty cool too. Fire's very alluring and very warm. So I don't know. It's like nature definitely, but then a tie between water and fire after that. I don't know. Very hard choice. Let's see. Ever know when you're going to debut the new model? Whenever it's ready. Whenever it is ready, it should be getting rigged this month sometime. So fingers crossed. Let's see. Everyone loves icy puns. Air so you can fly is pretty cool. Very true. Also, just having nice clean air all the time is pretty pog. And then light could be useful. It also could be very boring. Like lighting up a room versus like... giving plants sunlight and stuff, it just really depends how you use it. Don't tempt her, she keeps threatening to do a model reveal and ruin debut. Yeah, exactly. I do keep dropping things. I'm like, oh, I need some serotonin. Here you go, chat. Here's another sneak peek. Oh, I dropped this. Uh-oh. It's another sneak peek. I'm gonna have any of the model secret by the time we get to debut. Also, yes, if anyone wants to follow my Twitter, join my Discord, check out my YouTube, Twitch, or throw in there all my links in chat, and the rest are on my card. I'll be able to go to the places that are blocked a little more. Yeah, so the forest. Let's look through the forest. There must be something. That would probably be like healing or luck or something. Ooh, don't tell me that. I'm really into healing and luck stuff, so if light was that, I'd be down. I'd be down. Oh, let's go to our box really quick, chat. Oh wait, no. Get the stuff in the box. Don't put stuff in the box. Oh wait, I haven't learned this yet? Okay. Move that. Move that, move that, move that. Prior to debut, we'll be able to stitch all the sneak peeks into the full model. No, there's one thing that I will not show before debut. Absolutely will not at all. Badoop. I cannot tell you what it is. I missed the feet reveal. Some might say you were lucky. A lot of chat did not like that. I thought it was pretty funny though. Okay. Can we make anything? Psy candy? Oh, more weed terminator? Let's see. Backpack? Backpack? How do we open our backpack? How do I learn the recipe for the candy? All right, child, let's do this. I need one of these, one of these. Meow. Perfect. Gonna have the cute fox as a mascot. That's the secret reveal. Who knows? Perhaps, perhaps not. We'll just have to wait and see. Right, so let's move, move. How do I use this? Oh wait, didn't mean to move it over there. Not sure, chat. Go over here. Oh, it's 6 p.m. already. Caw, a crow? Witch, caw. Spoke? It's a witch's crow. Oh, it is a witch's crow. Witch returns, the witch returns. This is my first time coming here, though. The witch returns. Not exactly a listener, is he? Goods and services, caw. Goods and services. Witch's catalog. The witch's catalog? Always wanted to try it out. You need to head towards Highline, young lady. I can't just starve until I reach the village. After I find the village, I'll be staying there for a while before I go to Highline. Limited time only. Register now for a gift. Gah! Try the witch's catalog. Try the witch's catalog. They're handing out gifts as well, plus it's limited time only. Gah! Gift. Multi-purpose glue, kitchen accessories, a spork. In any case, I need the witch's catalog. Guess it wouldn't hurt to stay here for a while. You can buy ingredients or potion recipes from them. All right, let's register for now. Provertising, exactly. Thank you, ka, thank you. Visit employee, ka, visit employee. When? Work finished, closed for the day. Closed for the day! So suddenly? It's not easy getting the message across to witches' crows. I guess I should keep searching for the village. You never know when the witch's catalog will show up. Let's stick to the plan to find the village. We never found that cat either. It just kind of got forgotten. Oh, Michi! Hello, hello! Good to see you! Welcome in, welcome in! Oh, if only we could get over there. Hope you're having a wonderful day! Can we get a shout out for Michi, please? Haha! Thank you! I'm good, just enjoying some noms? Ooh. What kind of noms? Chat said they're having a burger. That made other chat want to have a burger. That made me want to have a burger. But I am having a... I have some ramen and seaweed snacks. Whoa! I've actually never had a... Well, no. I have never had a seaweed... That has not been on a sushi before. That's how I phrase that. Burger does sound really good. Just when the burger cravings left my head? No. You must remember the burger and be plagued by the burger as I am. What's up here? I'm having pork tenderloin for dinner, and I don't know what else. Haven't figured out any sides yet. I'm an alert, but I hope games are fun. Aw, thank you so much, Peachy! I hope your ramen is super tasty. Oh? Oh, hey! Adult honey pumpkin. Haven't been to the place behind it, and to go there we must get rid of it. This can't be helped to get to the new place. Ha, we already have one. Let's go. Okay, what are we missing here? The core. There we go. There's a little fox chat. He's stuck in the spider web. Heck. Oh, okay. That's how we get over there. Is there anything hiding behind these trees? Doesn't seem like it. All right. Rubrum. Oh, Virgil, there's someone stuck in the spider web. I think he's lost consciousness. Is he even alive? I don't know. He woke up. Who? I'm Ellie, an apprentice witch. A witch? Wow, this is my first time seeing an apprentice witch. It's my first time seeing a person caught in a spider web. Hehe. My name is Rubrum. I live in the village with Granny. Now I'm stuck in a big spider web. Doesn't seem to understand the gravity of the situation. Big spider web means there's a big spider nearby. You'll be quiet. Don't worry, you'll be fine. I'll help you down. You have to be careful when dealing with spider webs, Ellie. Looks pretty strong. One wrong move and you'll get stuck in it yourself. But what do? Maple herb works best against insects. Just one maple herb should be enough. It is maple herb. I have it. This should work. Like this. Oh! Personally, I prefer chicken nuggets over burgers. A good homemade chicken nugget can be good. Can be pretty tasty too. Are you okay? Yeah, probably. Can you walk? Yep. Let's go to the witch's house together. Okay. Hanging on the cobwebs, too boring. Meow, oh, he's zooming, chat. You made it all the way there in such a short time? Hehe, I'm fast, aren't I? Oh, look at his legs go, chat. Oh, if I can, thank you so much for the raid! Hello, hello! Welcome in! How was ZZZ? Hope it went well. Hope you pulled a good character. Come on, Ellie. Witch's house, witch's house. You're not really giving me a chance to catch up! Game is neat, good to hear! I kinda wanted to play it, and then I looked at my computer storage space. No one can catch a running child, they move like the wind. Are you still calling it the witch's house? It's our house now? I mean, we are a witch. It is still a witch's house. Computer storage space is forever the bane? Yeah. I only have 1 terabyte. So like I'll be careful with my storage. How energetic. Children of that age are bound to run around no matter where they are. So I like that too? Oh boy, your mother was out of tricks when it came to you. Look how derpy he looks, chat. You okay? You hurt? My legs are killing me. I can't walk any further. Why did this kid dash around so energetically? I'll carry you then. Give you treatment at the witch's house. Okay. Oh, we're carrying him! I don't remember this, chat. I don't remember us having to carry him. They changed so much. Isn't it heavy? It's not. Really? Really, don't talk to me now. We're just kidnapping a child, don't worry. Our village is just a little further from here. We can't pass through now because of the vines. Let's go to the witch's house for now and find a way. Yeah. He said not to talk to us. You're not heavy, but I'm getting tired. We're almost there. Wow, a witch's house. Thanks. He's gonna sleep in my bed, isn't he? How's your leg? It still hurts a bit. I have to hurry up and get back to the village. If not, Granny will scold me. Okay, leave it to me. I'll get rid of that giant prickly vine. Whoa, really? I'll get you back to your village, don't worry. Okay, thanks. Oh, before that, I should treat your leg first. Rubum, wait here for a moment. Alright. Casually kidnapping, yep. How do I... How do I make healing candy? How do I use my recipe? There we go. Wait. Okay, it takes those. Okay. So we need to grab this and grab this. Casually makes a neuralizer potion. Back the burger expedition was a bit of a flop. Oh no, I'm sorry to hear that. Was it just a bad burger or were they closed? It was close, we walked to a place that was just okay. Darn. That sucks to hear. Ba 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 ba. Okay, we go upstairs, we give child candy. Would you like to try this? Wow, what's this? Is it candy? Yeah, this candy can heal your legs. Wow, thanks, it looks delicious. Oh, it's good. Oh, this tastes awful. It's good for you. How are your legs now? Well, I think they feel better. Thanks, Ellie. Candy tastes awful. How'd you get caught in the spider web? I just came to the forest to play for a little bit. I lost track of time, and when I was finally going home, the road back was already blocked by the giant prickly vines. I was looking for another path when I heard the sound of a train. Oh, must be the one I was riding. I went towards the train, but a strange bird suddenly started chasing after me. Must have been that bird, not the train. It was that bird. I ran desperately into the depths of the forest, then I found a treasure map and got caught in a spider web as I was trying to pick it up. Treasure map! I saw a picture of a skeleton through the bushes. I saw in a children's book that it's a sign of pirates' hidden treasure. Shall we go check? What about the giant prickly vine? Oh, well, we can't do much about it yet. It wouldn't hurt to try. Let's go. We need to go to bed. It's like almost midnight. let's see. All good, all good. This game looks cute. I'm such a sucker for pixel art. Same! Pixel art can look adorable. Okay. Oh, gotta go back to where we found him. You pick up some sticks. Lots of sticks, chat. All right. Has there been any fishing yet? Not yet. We're still in the really early game. We need to check out this map. go back this way. Wait, pick up the rock. Need to upgrade our thingamajig. Our cauldron, yeah. Upgrade our cauldron. With rocks and sticks, I believe. This is a boom potion! I even went to the hidden library because I wanted to make it. I'm so lucky to find this here. They don't normally use a skeleton design as a symbol of luck, right? The point is, it looks like it can blow things up. There's something I want to blow up. Don't be too worked up. Shall we go try it right away? Miss this feeling. Not to destroy everything on the top of getting in trouble. Hey, what do you take me for? Boom potion. Don't you feel the almighty power just from the name? When in trouble, throw it. Break it if you can't have it? Sometimes it takes boldness to overcome a crisis. Don't you think it's strange that a boom potion is dropped in that secluded forest? Someone might have hidden it thinking that it's treasure, like Rubrum. Or someone might have accidentally dropped it. Accidentally dropped a boom potion? Whatever. What matters now is that I have a boom potion. Go, boom potion! What's going on? It won't even budge! It must be stronger than the secret door in the principal's office. What are these fragments coming out of? Huh? Where? At your feet. Look at this, Virgil. It's a prickly vine fragment. Seems to have worked a little bit. Vines will regenerate soon. With this, we might be able to figure out the exact species of the prickly vines. They aren't even in the encyclopedia. How are you going to figure that out? Oh, wouldn't a person living around here know something? Show the fragment to someone and ask them about it. Okay, let's see, chat. Welcome. Oh, is this a fragment of the prickly vines? Yes, do you know something about it? No idea at all, but I have something that might be helpful. Something that might be helpful? Ta-da! Universal Product Identifier. Wow, what's that? It's a tool made by some witch. With the power of the moon and the moonstone embedded here, you can find out the identity of any object. Really? Then hurry up and try it. I don't usually do this for free, but since you lifted my curse, just this one time. Wow, that's great. All right, here it goes. Hello, Nukem. Welcome and good to see you. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Huh? What? The prickly vine fragment disappeared? That's strange. Why did it disappear? Maybe because of a grudge against nature? Well, I don't think so. This tool just emits moonlight and analyzes the reflected light. No plant gets killed by sheer moonlight, right? Plant that withers once exposed to moonlight? Oh, it seems like something's coming up in my mind. Think, Ellie. This is something you learned in school. Oh, I remember now! Afraid of the moon! They're plants that get killed by moonlight! I see, this prickly vine is definitely afraid of the moon. So it withered once exposed to moonlight. I think I've also heard of plants like that. I'm glad the tool is working fine. Thank you. I think I can get rid of the prickly vines now. No, I'm the one who should be thankful. I'm counting on you. Alright. Exit dialogue. No. Oh, wait. Yeah. No, grab it! No! It escaped. Search the books in the witch's house to find info about the moonflower. Well, it's probably upstairs then. We will save. Not seeing it. Oh, wait. All right, let's get this started. Target Moonflower. People have died from reading too many books, haven't they? So much for all that confidence. I actually have a disease that kills me if I read too many books, you know. No more excuses. You've only gone through 3 books. Only? But come on, look at the size of them. It's too much work. Can't you read instead? You sure you want me to do that? Of course, we're friends, right? Looks like the next few lines are about the moonflower, though. What? Really? Let's see here. Bitter grape tea tree. Bitter grape tea tree? That's the tree we saw at the summit. The glowing one. The glow came from the butterflies. The tea leaves, blah, blah, blah. Tastes like grape. Strong sour taste. Oh, here it is. Blah, blah, blah. It's famous for its flowers, the moonflower. Moonflower! So it was here. There's still more information. Gathers moonlight most of the time, and on a moonless night, the moonflower blooms. A moonless night? The tree at the summit had blue moon butterflies flying around. So moonflower couldn't bloom because of the moonlight emitted by the butterflies. So if we get rid of the butterflies, the moonflower will bloom? Yeah, it's a commonly used method back in Lucerne Ortu. Gather moonlight with the butterflies, shoo them away, and collect the moonflower. Alright, let's get rid of the butterflies, make moon oil, and remove the prickly vines. What do we use to get rid of the butterflies? They don't like sunlight, so a sunlight potion is the common approach. I don't know where I can get the recipe for sunlight potion. Isn't it a limited recipe, too? Just like the recipe for moon oil I found in the workshop. Turn to the next chapter, maybe you'll find something. Huh, let's see. Wow! There are recipes for sunlight potion! So many of them! We're rich now! Are you positive they're usable? Sure. Wait, this one's covered with ink. This one's ripped. Can't all be damaged. Oh no. Ooh, luckily there's an intact piece. Store recipes between book pages. How clever. Usually, this is called shoving. Wording differs by person. Such times, I'd wish I were still at school. The limited recipes are usually disposable. At school, they give them away for free. So you want to go back to school? No way! My happy adventure's only just started. Alright, let's make a sunlight potion and get rid of those butterflies. Alright, what do we need for that, chat? Also, all this dialogue is, like, killing my voice, oh my goodness. Oh wait, Oh, thank you for the hydrate! Thank you! We need a fur thing. Which I have! Okay, we need to keep it at 5. Okay. Witch flower extract. Maple herb extract. And stir again. Ta-da! We did it! 99. I almost got a perfect score. Sunlight potion is ready. Let's go to the tree right away. Ellie, the moon oil is... Don't worry, I already have the ingredients. You already have them? Let's find the moonflower. Do you really want to go now? Have you done everything you want to do? Sure, I guess. Let's go. Great, they're stuck to the tree as expected. Wow, there's a ton of shining butterflies. We're going to make them all go away now, right? So bad for them all of a sudden. It's for the tree's sake. Hurry up and throw the potion. Okay, here goes. Oh. Wow, it's beautiful. Where are those butterflies going? Wouldn't they go back to where they came from? But the flower. Oh, over there, over there. It's so beautiful. Yeah, it's really, really beautiful. Now we just need to collect some moonflower and make moon oil. Rubrum, can you go to the prickly vines and wait for us there? We'll come as soon as the potion's ready. Oh, okay. Let's be waiting in front of the vines. Alright, let's go to the dispensary now. Should be able to make moon oil. Wait, you're not tossing him in to get some of the flowers for you? Apparently not. Oh my goodness, why is the music so loud now? Turn it down to skosh chat. Hello, Sir Mars! Welcome in, welcome in! Good to see you! Hope you haven't forgotten. For moon oil, you need phoenix feather, but there's no way we can find a phoenix around here. We have a phoenix feather right here. You told me all about it earlier. What? Oh, Ellie, that's not a good idea. Do that, we'll not be able to get back on the train! And you'll not make it to Highland. Which is always ready to help people, starting from those around her. That again. You just like it here better. I sip my coke. No, you can sip the coke, but not the griffin. Well, of course. You just don't like the witch's house in High Lion. That's true. Stop being childish. You're going to regret it later. No, Virgil. What I will regret is not doing this right now. I'm sure of it. You have to be smart about this. Ugh. Great, I have all the ingredients now. Ellie, you're worse than Arya sometimes. Oh, please, I'm nowhere near as good as my mother. That wasn't a compliment. Alright, now let's make moon oil. Well, we gotta... Hold Z to process, okay. Phoenix feather powder. Then we have to heat it to 1. Oh, that I'm already. Oh, goodness. Moon flower. Turn to the right. Turn clockwise. Boop. Alright. All made. Ba 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 ba. Woohoo! Moon oil is ready! Let's go get rid of the prickly vines now. A big old sausage and black olive calzone. That sounds really good. Here, now let's hurry up and get rid of the annoying vines. Huh? You won't suffer any loss because of me, will you? Don't worry about it. I'm the one who decided to do it. It's what I really wanted to do. And this is my choice. Thanks, Ellie. It's no big deal. You can come to the witch's house anytime you want. Wait, how does he know? I have no idea. Are you going to stay here? Yeah, I think I'll stay here throughout my apprenticeship. Really? Really? Really. Let's spend more time together, Rubrum. Okay, let's spend more time together, Ellie. Hurry up and go home for now. Granny must be worried. I'll find you later. Okay, see you in a bit. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know how he knows, because he left... a while before we mix the potion. I love this. I think I'm gonna buy it later. Yeah, this is our second time playing it, actually. And it was really good the first time, too. They have changed some stuff, but it's been really fun. I've been liking it a lot. Connecting like a saint. This place seems fun to you, that's all. Virgil, try not to say stuff that makes me sound like a bad guy, will you? It's a happy ending for all. If I have fun and they're happy, isn't it? Will the professors get angry? Mother like daughter, that's what they'll say. That's great. It's not a compliment. Alright, let's head to the village now.
To the village!
In the village at last! Yeah, it's a village. What kind of village would it be? I hope a lot of fun things happen here. Not sure about the fun things, but we apparently have some trouble. This life I've always dreamed about. Let's hurry up and go! Oh, there's so many weeds, chat. It's quite a dull sight. Virgil! So this is the village you're going to spend 3 years in. You like it? You feel like going back to Highline again? What the heck happened here? What are all these prickly vines doing here? I'm so excited. I don't even know how to comment. And something seems strange. Everyone would find it a strange sight. Why do these prickly vines grow only on houses? No, that's not what I meant. It feels like I've been here before for some reason. Is that some sort of cliche and meaningless foreshadowing? There's no way you've ever been here. They don't come this far for the witch school picnic. Something feels familiar, really. Let's find her room first. Tavern! Oh no, she remembers the previous playthrough! Oh heck. Oh, Ellie. Thanks for helping me get home. That's nothing special. Kinda looks like no one's in the village. So many of them left after the prickly vines started growing like mad. Now I only have Ardens in my house. I see, you must be bored. No, it's okay, because Granny and Arden are here. There are also lots of fun things in the forest. Oh, Granny wants to meet you. Granny? Yeah, she's the village chief. She was actually the village chief? Oh, not is. She used to be. You can find her in the back. Okay, I'll go. Okay, take care. Welcome, Miss Witch. You've done a great job with helping my grandchild. Thank you. No, I'm the one who received help. Please relax. It will be fine. I'm Ellie, an apprentice witch. Many witches don't look their age. Alright, I shall save the formality. Welcome to Risteria, Ellie. I'm Enite, chief of this village. Both the village chief and the village are in bad shape, though. What happened in this village? What are all those prickly vines? Have you taken a look around the village? Yes, I saw the houses covered with prickly vines. Didn't look like ordinary prickly vines. It happened 3 years ago. Those prickly vines started to grow all of a sudden and destroyed the houses one by one. Why did they start growing all of a sudden? Actually, these are not the first prickly vines growing in the village. The village used to have white prickly vines growing at its entrance. But the prickly vines that appeared 3 years ago looked completely foreign to us. At first, they were saying things like God's punishment, monster, or witch's curse. Wipe off your drool, Ellie. It's a serious story. There were lots of rumors, but no one actually knew why. They started growing all of a sudden without any explanation. What happened to the villagers? Nobody was hurt. I know that prickly vines grow fast, but they aren't supposed to be fast enough to hurt anyone. People had no place to live and could only leave the village. Now only Arden and I remain in the village. Don't worry now, I'll help you. I'll remove the prickly vines and bring the villagers back. Thank you so much for saying that. It's too late now. What? All the houses have been ruined already and everyone left. Instead of a village, the current Wisteria is more like some ruins housing two seniors reluctant to leave. Ellie, you should also leave now. It's better to go to the place you were originally planning to go. But I'm not forcing you. You can stay in the village for as long as you want. Leave when the train comes. This place is not a village anymore. That can't happen. Highline is boring as hell. Virgil, language! Ellie, the villagers are all gone. Even if the prickly vines are removed, what's the meaning? This is still a village. The villagers will be willing to come back. Even if the prickly vines disappear, why would they come back to a remote village like this? Everyone would want to come back. Ellie, people left and time has passed. I don't think those driven out by the prickly vines will ever want to come back to these ruins. No, they would definitely want to come back. It's a wonderful village that you've been developing all your life, Unite. Don't let these weird prickly vines take over the village. Yeah, you're right, but... let's call it a day and continue tomorrow. You look tired too. Rubrum looks like he needs the rest as well. Okay. Don't be too hard on Rubrum. Yeah, okay. Get some rest. You too, Enite. Heck yeah, chat. Got to the village. What are you trying to do? Enite's right. It requires a lot of imagination to call this place a village. Says who? It's still a village even if there's no houses. Fine, but it's by no means a village if there are not even people. People will come back. How can you be so sure? This is your first time in this village. You're just being ridiculous. No, I definitely heard their mind. The villagers want to come back. Where did you hear it? You haven't met any of them. That, I don't know. Maybe I heard it in a dream. So you're being ridiculous. No, you are. No, it isn't. It's a village that Enite has lived in for all of her life. Other people must be as fond of it as she is. You know, you also just met Enite for the first time. I can tell, even if we met for the first time, my heart was beating so fast. Who would fix the houses even if the prickly vines are removed? Only two seniors and one child in the village. You're right, Virgil. Correct. We also need a carpenter to fix the houses. Anyway, the first villager returning has to be a carpenter. Okay, find a carpenter capable of flying, then. And they probably need six arms. Stop being sarcastic, Virgil, okay? Have some sleep. You'll find such a carpenter in your dream. Stop being sarcastic! The house was up a gas leak or something. This girl is tripping. Just optimistic. To a giant flying carpenter ant. Go bed.
Oh. 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 Double shoulder pop chat. Make sure you stretch.
Oh. I heard that. Oh, I'm sorry. It was my shoulders. Did you meet the flying carpenter? I don't know. It didn't seem like I had a dream, but I don't remember anything. Oh, thank you, Jake. Don't apologize. Do it again. I can't. Can't do it again. Did both of them already. I was not shrimping, though. I will say that. And I will hydrate now. Are you nervous or something, since this is your first day as an apprentice witch? Of course not. So you ready to start your first day as an apprentice witch? Of course! Do you know what to do? Let me ask what Enite thinks first. Although she was naturally approved, I shall wait till I actually hear it. We'll check out the carpenter's house to try to get rid of the vines. Remember that we don't have any phoenix feather left. It'll work out somehow. Let's go to Enite first. Hello, Yamamoto! Welcome in, welcome in. Hope we're having a wonderful day. Alright, chat. I think we're gonna start wrapping up here. Wow. Wow? Wow? Denied! I started streaming a little early, I'm sorry! And this game is actually, like, killing my voice a little bit. I can tell. It hurts to talk. I don't know what it is. I guess it's just all the dialogue. I feel like we've definitely had more dialogue-heavy games. But, oh my goodness. Something about it is just killing my voice. So let me turn off that. So we have not all pixely anymore. Also, Blue Lily? Hopefully I said that correctly. Thank you so much for the follow. Thank you. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Drink lots when you have a talkie game? Yeah. I don't think I drank enough. I did sip some water every now and then, but I don't think it was enough. So, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. I'm ready to not talk for like a few hours. Yeah, should I figure I'd start wrapping up a touch earlier than usual? Because I have a whole lot of Orbeez to pick out of my carpet now before my dogs eat them. And I'm very hungry. I'm very hungry. But I'm really happy that we got to get back to Little Witch in the Woods. They did change some things, and I think it's for the better so far. I've really liked everything that they've done. I don't remember their crafting stuff being this hard. I remember just selecting the stuff and getting the potion. So having it actually be a little bit more interactive was really neat. And also, like, the cave next to our house, that wasn't there before. Just, I'm very intrigued to see what else they changed and added, and I'm excited to go fishing. So that's gonna be fun. Let's see. Who should we go raid? Maybe we'll go raid Blue Pixie. She's playing some Kingdom Hearts. I really like Kingdom Hearts. It looks like she just started too. Orbeez in your carpet? What happened? Hudo happened. He came in and started shooting me with his new Orby gun. So now I have to pick up all the Orbeez that are in the carpet. So that's gonna be fun. Some of them also broke. I have a few broken ones on my desk. Yeah. I was muted for quite a while he was running the his gun and smacking me with the Orbeez. I was like, okay. I'll take it, I guess. Someone's in trouble? No. He just likes to mess with me a lot. Especially when I'm streaming. Silly. Mischievous? 100% mischievous. Griffin abuse reported? Nah. Hudo would never. Well, yeah, I had a great time. I forgot how much this game makes me talk. I'm excited to go not talk for the next 2 hours and have some food. I hope y'all have a wonderful 4th of July for those of you that celebrate this American Freedom Day. Also, for you Canadians, I hope you had a wonderful Canada Day. Yeah, I'll see you guys tomorrow at around the same time as today. Probably a touch later at our normal early time, 1 p.m. We started at 12:30 today. So just a little later than today's stream. Have you managed to catch your tail, the tail end of your stream? It was cute and fun, a good pick. Yes, Thor, it's so cute in it too. I really like how derpy she looks. And the sprites for it are also very pretty. I can't wait for us to get started, because we just barely finished what I think is the quote-unquote tutorial part of it. Like, we just scraped the beginning of the game. So I can't wait for us to get back to it. Maybe next week? We'll see. But yeah, chat, let's go raid Blue Pixie. Thanks for the stream, of course! Thank you all for coming! Here's all my socials. If anyone wants to follow my Twitter, check out my Discord, check out my YouTube, Twitch, or Throne. There are all my links in chat. The rest are on my card. And here is my raid message! If you don't have my emotes, feel free to substitute in ones that you do have, that you are able to use. I will see you guys tomorrow. If I don't see you tomorrow, I hope you have a wonderful weekend! Make sure to stay hydrated, chat, okay? It's been pretty hot out there. Alright, chat, have a good day and weekend if I don't see you tomorrow. Goodbye, chat. Goodbye. Thank you for hanging out with me today. Happy 4th.